youth sports has become an important outlet for kids. It's their chance to see friends, improve skills, learn to play fair, and have fun.
Okay, time to work together. Pound it, guys!
And after a year of uncertainty, many of you are finally getting back onto the field. So here at Nick News, we want to remind you that even if you're not a natural-born athlete, it doesn't matter. It's all about your love of the game, any game. Welcome to Nick News, Kids in Sports. I'm Jamie Yukis, and we've got some of the best sports stories you need to know about.
First, we'll take you to a California high school basketball game where LeBron James, Drake, and Dwayne Wade all sit in the front row.
Then, CBS News correspondent Vladimir Duthier heads to Spring, Texas, where Jordan Chiles, gymnastics silver star and Simone Biles' BFF, currently trains. Is Paris 2024 in her future?
That's a good question.
And I travel to Orange County, California, and introduce you to the 14-year-old daredevil who refuses to let her wheelchair slow her down.
Where does your life go?
Maybe to the Paralympics.
So that's the goal?
Yeah.
It all starts right now. Hi, I'm Jamie Yukis, and you're watching Nick News, Kids and Sports. You know, getting involved in youth sports is a rite of passage for just about every single kid on the planet. In fact, kids are introduced to a boatload of sports even before they learn how to read. But there are some challenges, like COVID-19. It's no secret that sports were sidelined during the pandemic. But it didn't stop you from finding new ways to continue to take part in the sports you just can't live without.
Soccer.
Lacrosse.
Baseball.
Tennis.
Football.
Gymnastics.
Karate.
Ice skating.
Softball.
Volleyball.
Kickball.
Yep, sports are back and better than ever. And today, our goal is to inspire you to get out there, join a team, and make sure you always feel like a winner. Speaking of winners, you're about to go inside a California high school where some of the sporting events are like being at a Hollywood movie premiere. It's called Sierra Canyon High School, and I spent the day with a basketball phenom who reveals what it's like to have A-list celebrities watch your every move and be called the most Instagrammed high school in America. It may seem like an ordinary high school basketball game, but Sierra Canyon is no ordinary high school. It's an NBA factory, sending an unprecedented amount of kids to the pros. And they are some of the biggest names in the NBA. Zaire Williams, Brandon Boston Jr., Dwayne Washington Jr., Marvin Bagley III, and a 2021 slam dunk contender, Cassius Stanley. What do they all have in common? These all-stars are graduates of Sierra Canyon High School. In just 16 years, the school has won 12 California state championships, but it takes a special type of teenager to play any of the 17 sports offered at Sierra Canyon, especially when celebrities like LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, Gabrielle Union, Kevin Hart, P. Diddy, and Drake all sit in the front row. The day we visited, we met with a student athlete who dominates the sporty plays. He's basketball phenom Amari Bailey, who's ranked as the number one shooting guard in his 2022 class. There's this saying I've heard, the Lakers, the Clippers, and Sierra Canyon.
Yes.
How does it feel to be a part of that group?
Honestly, it's just a blessing. Like, we have that much attention being brought to us, and we just get to display ourselves and express ourselves on the highest level. I think that's what's dope about Sierra Canyon.
It all started to take shape when sons of NBA players like LeBron James Jr., Scottie Pippen Jr., and Zaire Wade firmly set the school in the national spotlight. Now, it's the most Instagrammed high school in America.
I have to wonder, I walk through your gym, and I'm sitting there thinking, I mean, it looks like a professional,
yeah,
right? Like a professional arena. What is it like when the crowd is going crazy?
It's like one of the best feelings, honestly. As much as it is a sport, it is entertainment, and as long as I'm entertaining the crowd and my team win, I think they go hand in hand pretty well.
The basketball superstar is definitely grounded in reality, and he's the first to admit his road to Sierra Canyon was not easy.
What brought you to Sierra Canyon?
I was looking for a new fit. I moved cross country from Chicago to LA, and I landed at Sierra Canyon. It changed my life.
What way?
They let you be yourself and fully express yourself at the highest level.
It's not just athletics that dominate Sierra Canyon. Skill, determination, and a strong work ethic are not only expected on the court or field, but first and foremost, in the classroom.
What does he learn in that moment?
How do you balance the homework and the travel and trying to be a teenager?
We get a lot of help from my academic support teachers that help me get my work done and just help me get ready and stay on top of my stuff.
Jim Scrumbus has been the head of school at Sierra Canyon for 15 years.
There is this idea that Sierra Canyon is this athletic powerhouse.
Yes.
And that's what you want the school to be. Is that true?
It's happened, and it's happened because of the hard work of a lot of our coaches and our athletic administrators. That's not what drives me every day. What drives me and our faculty every day is making sure that we're delivering the best possible education in an environment that is truly diverse and inclusive, that allows for extracurricular activities that run the gamut.
One of those coaches is Andre Chevalier, or as his team calls him, Coach Dre. He's been leading the basketball team for 5 years.
When they're out there playing on the court, you look up in the stands and there's celebrities watching them play. How do you keep the guys' heads in the game?
But I think it is definitely a distraction at first. But they want to be NBA players, and there's going to be celebrities sitting on the side of the NBA game. So if we can give them that experience now, it's only going to help them when they step to the next level, whether that's college, whether it's pro overseas, pro NBA.
A powerhouse player in his own right, Coach Dre is a Hall of Famer at his alma mater, California State University Northridge. And like Amari, the road to success was not easy for him either.
For you to catch the ball.
Tell me about your hand.
I was born this way, but my hand is my greatest gift, right? People would consider it to be a hindrance, but over time you realize that I wouldn't be the person that I am today if I didn't have this pushing me and motivating me and challenging me every single day to, for me, like, be equal to everyone. So we all have challenges and things that we have to deal with. So I just use it as an example of, like, you know, this is what this is. It's another obstacle that you have to deal with. Deal with it.
Do you ever think that you've taken your work ethic and you want them to see it and apply it in their own lives?
Just try to keep on playing hard. And that's what I tell the kids all the time. Just play hard and things will happen for you.
What advice would you have for yourself if you're 7 years old?
I would sit 7-year-old Amari down and tell him whatever it is that you have on your mind that you want to do, you're more than capable of accomplishing it. Don't let anyone ever tell you that you can't do whatever it is that you'd like to do. Because at the end of the day, whoever's telling you that, they didn't get to fulfill their dream, so they're just gonna tell you that you can't do yours, so.
Did you have somebody tell you that you wouldn't be able to achieve being an elite basketball player?
A couple of my teachers asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up, and I told them I was gonna go to the NBA. And she was like, oh, well. It was like, you know, that's 0.1%. I told her I believe that I'm a part of that.
Coming up, she's the Olympic medalist who once believed the sport she loved didn't want her anymore. Find out how Jordan Chiles bounced back when we return.
What are the most popular sports for girls and boys?
Hey kids, it's Devin Booker, and I play for the NBA's Phoenix Suns. The most popular sport for both boys and girls is a sport that I love most, basketball. Over 450,000 girls and 550,000 boys play for a school team. Baseball and softball rank second.
One of my favorite events at the Olympics is gymnastics. It's mesmerizing to watch the gymnasts twist, flip, and fly, especially when you're watching Olympic silver medalist Jordan Chiles. I mean, how crazy is this? Jordan stepped up to the mat last minute when she filled in for Simone Biles on not one, but two events. And she nailed it. CBS News correspondent Vladimir Duthier is in Spring, Texas, where he asked Jordan about the first time she stood on the Olympic podium. Hey, Vlad.
Hey, Jamie. This is the World Champion Center, the training ground for Olympic gymnast Simone Biles and Jordan Chiles. And we just watched Jordan perform on the vault and the floor, and it was just absolutely spectacular, as you would imagine it would be. What I love, though, about Jordan Chiles is not just her love and her passion for gymnastics, it's the love and support she gets every day from her family and the love and support that she gets from her BFF, the greatest of all time, Simone Biles.
USA! USA!
It was something that I'll never regret, and I always will cherish those moments with every girl that was standing on that podium with me.
I was excited to meet Jordan at the gym she calls her second home, but it's Vancouver, Washington, where she was born and raised, that helped build Jordan into the Olympian she is today.
Vancouver. Your hometown, right? Through a welcome home parade for you.
Yes.
How did that feel?
It was amazing. I wasn't expecting that many people to show
what?
Up. I literally felt like honored, which is pretty cool. I've never felt that in my life, so being able to feel that was an amazing thing.
You've never felt like that before?
No, in the sport of gymnastics, my whole entire life until about 2018, I felt like I wasn't wanted in this sport. So actually feeling that was something that I was just very, very proud of because it made me feel like I was someone.
I like the gymnastics.
Jordan trained in Washington from the time she was 6 years old and quickly rose to the top of the elite gymnastics world. But it was in 2018 when troubles began. Jordan placed 11th in the U.S. Nationals and would not be chosen to compete in the World Championships. Jordan saw this as a sign that her time in the sport she loved was over.
I had put my whole entire life behind me to be in the sport, and like the dedication throughout that whole time period just wasn't there. There was just a lot of stuff that was going on in that time frame of me realizing like maybe I'm just not wanted in the sport.
But someone did want her in the sport. Simone Biles, the world's greatest gymnast, took Jordan under her wing and the two became as close as sisters.
It was after 2018 World Selection Camp. She gave me a huge, huge, huge talk because that's when I was like, I don't know if I want to do this sport anymore.
Right.
So she was like, you can do this, you can do that. And I was like, okay, like, yeah, from you, the Olympian, yeah, totally, I can do whatever.
Social media quickly exploded with the hashtag Biles and Childs. And after a year and a half of training with her BFF, it was no surprise Jordan finished third at the 2020 Olympic trials and named to Team USA.
Simone Biles is out.
Simone Biles is focusing on her mental health.
What was it like for you to now be the rock for her when she chose to opt out of competing at some of the events?
That was the most devastating thing in my life. Never thought I would have to put my feet in some huge shoes like that. Something I never want to do again, and I told her that. I was like, I never want to do this again. And it's just something that my heart was aching really, really bad. Even throughout the whole competition, I might have not shown it, but it was just really hard for me not to compete with my best friend because we've made it through every single competition together, and then at this moment in time, it was just like, why now?
What happened next is now an entry into Olympic history. Jordan Childs nailed her performance on the bars, putting Team USA in striking distance of the gold medal. And just as she did 3 years before, her best friend, Simone, was by her side, supporting and cheering her on.
She came out there, she supported us, she gave us those encouraging words like, you guys got this, you can do whatever. And so having that support and having her there with us helped us even more, and that's what made it fun. And that's why we ended how we ended, and still to this day, this silver medal was for her. We are the called the fighting for a reason.
And when you say the silver medal is for her, unwrap that for me.
This medal is for her because although she may not have been out there, she still contributed something. She still contributed her love. She still contributed her support.
And now that the Tokyo Olympics are behind Jordan, the question is, will she try to compete in Paris 2024?
2024 is something that I've thought of. It's definitely high up in the air. After 2020 Olympics, I was just like, you know, I have the experience. I might be able to do another one, and I think I'm capable of doing it, so we'll see.
So here's what's next for Jordan Childs. She's packing up that silver medal, and she is headed to UCLA. Jamie, she will be competing for the UCLA Bruins. We'll be watching. Back to you, Jamie.
So cool. Vlad, thank you. When we come back, meet the 14-year-old skateboarder in a pink helmet who refuses to let her wheelchair slow her down. But first, watch this.
What colors make the Olympic rings?
Hey kids, it's Lori Hernandez from the 2016 Olympic Games. I won team gold and individual silver on the bounce beam. The five interlocking Olympic rings are blue, yellow, black, green, and red. Each ring symbolizes one of the five continents competing at the Olympics: Africa, North and South America, Asia, Europe, and Australia / Pacific Rim.
Hi, I'm Katherine Eunice Schwarzenegger. My grandma, Eunice Kennedy Shriver, would have been 100 years old this year. She founded the Special Olympics in the early 1960s after she saw how unfairly people with intellectual disabilities were being treated, including her sister Rosemary. She took action, and today, the Special Olympics are in 193 countries all over the world, with more than 5.5 million athletes involved in their programs.
This is 14-year-old Lucy Castillo. Lucy has been in a wheelchair her entire life, but she doesn't let it stop her. So I traveled to Orange County, California to find out what inspires her to never stop reaching for the stars. Lucy Castillo is a 14-year-old athlete slash daredevil slash sports enthusiast.
I surf, skate, and play basketball.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome. What do you think?
This is cool.
We met at a local skate park to test out her new set of wheels.
Whoa, look at that helmet.
She and her mom, Elizabeth, wasted no time tackling the new adventure.
Ooh, I think she'll do it.
Does any of this make you nervous?
Not anymore.
No?
Not anymore, but honestly, like, if I show her I'm nervous, then she'll be nervous, so I gotta.
Lucy was born with spina bifida, a birth defect of the spine affecting 1,400 babies in the U.S. each year. Spina bifida causes physical and intellectual disabilities, ranging from mild to severe.
Ah! Do you have any fear?
No, I'm confident.
Yeah?
On the course, fear does eventually set in.
I'm scared. All right, get
down. Well, then don't push it.
Get back.
Testing out a new set of wheels on a new course can be frightening for any skater.
God, I feel like I'm about to fall.
You feel like you're gonna fall?
But never one to let fear get in her way.
Good job, baby. Good
that was
job,
great. Baby. Awesome. How'd it feel?
Good. I think I felt more air on that one.
You get a big smile on your face when you bounce. Where does your life go?
Maybe to the Paralympics.
So that's the goal?
Yeah.
And what would it be like to compete at the Paralympics?
Kind of scary because many people are watching.
I know, you seem a little shy. Are you a little shy?
Sometimes, yeah.
Every spina bifida kid is so different. Today we'll be fine, tomorrow something can happen with her shunt in her brain and she'll need surgery. I never knew Lucy would be active in sports because when I found out I was pregnant, they told me that she wouldn't have a quality of life.
Elizabeth refused to allow Lucy's life to be limited by her prognosis.
I would just sign her up for everything. And I was like, oh no, she's gonna do this, but we're gonna try it.
Lucy spent a weekend at a camp hosted by the Challenged Athletes Foundation, where she tried her hands at sports for the first time. Organizations like CAF make it possible for kids with special needs to find a better quality of life through sports by funding the necessary equipment like prosthetic limbs and custom athletic chairs.
I think my favorite is skating.
And why is that?
Because I get to do it with a group of friends and have fun.
I hear you have a lot of friends.
Yes.
Off the court, Lucy enjoys dancing and attends the Rolettes dance camp, where she gets to reconnect with her friends from all over the world.
What makes dancing fun is dancing with people and meeting new people.
One, two, three, four.
Chelsea Hill is the founder of the Rolettes.
When you're young and you're in a wheelchair, there's not a lot of people in your community that are like you.
She was a competitive dancer before a car accident left her paralyzed. She created the Rolettes out of a lack of community in the dance space.
When I first became paralyzed, there was no dance classes for people with disabilities, and I wanted to normalize wheelchair dancing.
And she has. She and Lucy have been tearing up the dance floor for the past 4 years.
When I first met Lucy, all she was doing was smiling. She was like, look what I can do, look at this, look at that. She's just this ball of energy.
Sometimes if people ask me, I'll answer. I educate people through the tricks I do in my chair because I think people should know more about me. If you see someone in a wheelchair, go up and treat them the way you would treat any other person.
I really hope that people understand how important it is to be inclusive. Anyone can become injured or diagnosed or have an illness that has them use a wheelchair.
People don't expect to see people in a wheelchair thrive, and she's thriving. And I know she kind of gets nervous and scared, but she pushes through that.
Sports have given me confidence, independence, a lot of friends.
When we come back, it's sports quiz time. Time for kids reporter Rory Hu has some of sports' most challenging questions. How many can you get right? Find out next.
What are the countries they call soccer football?
To answer this question, we turn to James Brown, host of the NFL Today on CBS. Hey, JB.
great question. What countries call this, which is a soccer ball?
That's a volleyball, JB.
Football. A number of countries around the globe. Think Mexico, South America. Huge portions of the European continent call this football. And quite simply, it's because you kick this with your foot. Now, if I were to play soccer, oh my gosh, ask your parents what a bunion is. I've got bunions, and after the game, I will be walking around, ooch, ouch, ouch, ooch, ouch. So therefore, I would prefer football because you get to throw this one.
You know what time it is? It's Kids Sports Quiz Time. And who better to test your knowledge about sports than Time for Kids reporter Rory Hu. Hey, Rory.
Hi, Jamie. Question number one. How long is a marathon? A, 5 miles, B, 13.5 miles, C, 26 miles, or D, 26.2 miles? The answer is D, 26.2 miles. Next question. What is the only sport to be played on the moon? A, tennis, B, golf, C, volleyball, or D, football? The answer is B, golf. Moving on, in what year were women allowed to compete in the modern Olympic Games? A, 1900, B, 1924, C, 1944, or D, 1952? The answer is A, 1900. Moving on to our last question for today. Who was the first Olympic gymnast to receive a perfect score? A, Simone Biles, B, Nadia Comaneci, C, Laurie Hernandez, or D, Mary Lou Retton? For this question, we ask Olympic gold medalist Nadia Comaneci to answer.
In 1976, in Montreal, Canada, I was the first gymnast in Olympic history to be awarded the perfect 10 for my performance on the uneven bars. During my gymnastics career, I won 9 Olympic medals and 4 world championship medals.
Thanks, Nadia. Back to you, Jamie.
Thanks, Rory. Great job. And that's it, kids. We hope you learned today that being involved in sports or playing on a team teaches all those life lessons that are super important. Right, Patrick?
That makes sense to me.
From all of us here at Nick News, thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.